Kirsha Kaechele, the artist behind the Ladies Lounge exhibition at Mona in Tasmania, is being sued for gender discrimination. Jason Lau from New South Wales has launched legal action after being refused entry to the Women Identifying Only exhibit last April. The matter ended up in a Tassie tribunal this week with Kirsha and her supporters dancing their way out of the hearing. Oh, it's impressive. And joining us from the luxury of the Ladies Lounge is Kirsha. Kirsha, what are you actually allowed to tell me about your location right now?
Well, I'm in the Ladies Lounge at Mona. It's a beautiful space for women to escape this strange and disjointed world of male domination and relish in the pure company of women while being served by a retinue of butlers who live to give us every dream and joy.
Hang on. So there are men in there?
Oh, yes. It's a very inclusive space. Any man under the age of 25 who's good-looking can apply for a position as a butler.
Can I ask what happened in there? I've been there before with my girlfriend and her friends. They all went in and I waited out the front and then I begged to find out what happened. No one said anything. What's going on? Could you please tell me, maybe?
I can't really reveal all of the details to you, but, you know, it's really wonderful. Some of the most important artwork in our collection is in this space. Some of the highest value paintings in the world are in this space. We have Picasso's, Sidney Nolan's, beautiful antiquities from Africa, Mesopotamia. The most valuable pieces, really, in my opinion, amounting to a value far greater than the entire collection.
I honestly think you're a liar.
No, it's absolutely a fact.
Kirsha, what is the main point of this book?
Look, women really need a break. Men rule the world. They're in charge of everything. I think we just need a little place to get away and have a nice time. Some people love it, especially women. Other people are genuinely concerned about the discriminatory qualities of the ladies' lounge. And there are, of course, all of the men who I'd say, in general, are in a state of hysteria about it. The men are hysterical, and they're saying that I'm hysterical, and they're right, I'm hysterical.
Is there any part of you that thinks that it's all just a waste of time?
No, I love every moment of it. It's actually a complete joy, and I'm extremely grateful to Mr. Lau for the lawsuit because we get to exercise the argument. And I think it's completely fascinating. The law doesn't provide for a situation like this, so actually, from a legal standpoint, nobody knows how it will go. I could tell the judge wants to side with us very badly, but whether he feels he can or not is unclear.
So what happens if he doesn't?
The ladies' lounge will have to close because the requirement would be that it opens to men, and that's not happening, so...
I'll try and just contain Waleed's hysteria right here with me on the desk. Kirsha, what a time. Thank you very much for your time and we wish you well.
Thank you.
Now, Samuel, you may not have been allowed into the ladies' lounge.
You know, I feel a bit like we've seen it now.
Yeah, but we didn't see all those amazing paintings.
There's nothing there.
Really?
We have a first-hand
account. I've been there. I went there 10 days ago.
And there's what? There's nothing in there. My girlfriend said it was the best experience of her life.
Well, she's lying.
Well, maybe she's maybe it's just because you weren't there.
Oh, a bit of peace and quiet.
Oh, hang on.
Turned into an episode of Jerry Springer all of a sudden.
But honestly, what was it?
It was just very dark.
Okay.
And you just stumbled about knocking into people, women, I suppose. Yeah. And then you went out. I mean, there was nothing to it, really.
Just stumbling about in the dark sounds like a men's lounge.
Yeah, that's...
Yeah.
Yeah, I definitely know. That is very similar to a men's
true
lounge.
True equality, I see.
Absolutely.